VRAM in Star Citizen. How much do you need in 2023? Now, in the past, I did some testing on this, and I found that there are occasions where you can run out of VRAM. I did some testing with the RX 5500, the 4GB and the 8GB card. We had Gen 4 and Gen 3 PCIe, but in both cases, the 4GB card performed worse. So there are scenarios with this game where running out of VRAM will hurt your performance. I also did some testing with the 8GB 1070 from NVIDIA versus the 1660 Ti from NVIDIA as well, which has got 6GB of VRAM. And as you'll see on the screen, you've got this red that comes up on the display info display. And that is saying something is going wrong. The engine is not a fan of this. And basically, we are running low on VRAM. And what I found with this sequence was that as you go through Lawville, there are points where the 1660 Ti drops in performance because it's run out of VRAM. At least that's what I think was going on. So what I've done, I've got my 4080 with 16GB of VRAM, and I've gone and tested in lots of different locations in-game, and I'm going to put on the screen 1080p, 4040p, and 4K, and show you how much VRAM is being used up. And then we've got a couple of clips from CIG just to tell us kind of what's going to happen in the future with VRAM, because on one hand, maybe we need to worry about this, and on the other hand, maybe we don't. So we're in Lawville to start with. You'll see as you go up your resolution, the GPU memory total, that top line, we'll focus on that, is going up. And so at 4K, you're using nearly 9GB of memory. Similar situation in Area 18 in Arc Corp. 4K is closing in on 9GB, but the other two are solidly under 8. We've got this scene which is looking over Hurston with a space station in sight and you're in a ship. And again, there's a big bit of scaling between 1080p, 1440p and 4K. Into Orizon. Orizon actually doesn't seem too bad. We've got, again, near 8GB of GPU memory total used for 4K, but the other two aren't too bad. And this is a bit surprising in some ways. You'd expect Orizon to be heavier, but maybe the actual platforms, there's not too much going on. And compared to Arc Corp, where there's buildings everywhere, maybe it's just not too bad. I went to one of the moons to just go to this outpost. And you'll see on this planet, it's not as bad as it is in the cities. We're under 8GB at 4K and around the 6GB for 1080p. And in space where there's nothing going on, under 8GB at 4K and still around the 6GB mark at 1440p and 1080p. So based on that, you might kind of be expecting me to say, well, around 8GB gives you a bit of headroom at 1080p and 1440p. And then maybe you need at least 10 for 4K. What's interesting though is that when I tested the 3080, which you got 10GB, my card at least, there were moments in the long run where it was slowing down, similar to the 1660 Ti. It seemed to be running out of VRAM. It was going red on the, it was flashing red on the display info 4 display. And so in some ways that doesn't really matter because that isn't really a 4K card. The only cards that I have been recommended for 4K would be 4080 and 4090. And then the 7900 XTX, maybe the XT. And so what I think is going to be the case for most people here is that unless you're pushing 4K, you've probably got plenty of VRAM. And if you are pushing 4K, you are probably running a card that's got enough VRAM anyway, because those cards I've just mentioned there have all got loads. So it doesn't really matter. I think what's interesting is where CIG are going with this.
Now, one thing we are going to do is with Gen 12, as a necessity of the way Vulkan works, the memory management is much more explicit. Basically, rather than DirectX or NVIDIA Intel managing the memory for you, it's left largely to yourself as a developer. But as a result of that, we are much more strict how we use the memory. And what we're going to do is what a few other games have done, is type of expose that to you in the advanced graphics options so you can see exactly what memory you're using. And type of balance that as you see fit. So if you want, think you want any more texture memory and then you will sacrifice something else, then that's your choice. And you can type of see how this is, how we're adapting rather than it being hidden from you, which slightly is at the moment. And the other thing that a lot of people maybe don't realize is resolution you run the game has a huge impact on the amount of memory. So when I'm saying like 4GB is okay, if you're trying to run the game, you know, 8K, well, 4K widescreen or something, you are taking a huge amount of memory for the bare bones, just getting the screen rendered without any geometry or textures in there. So you leave very little room for them. So if we expose it to you and show it to you, it'll be much more clear, and people that don't have as much memory will be able to make a smarter decision on how they want to use it. If they're interested, obviously we'll have automatic settings do our best job.
So that's Ali Brower explaining that basically we are going to get graphics menu options that will effectively allow us to manage our own memory. So for those of us who've got less memory in our cards, we should be able to tweak and turn down settings. Most modern games have got this sort of feature where it will show you how much VRAM is being used up by a certain setting, and you'll be able to change it and see what you're estimated to use. So in some ways, that's good news for people. At this stage, they're kind of saying they're still going to support people with 4 gigabytes and 6 gigabyte cards. We'll see how well that pans out in the future. But for those of us who've got loads of VRAM, they then went on to say this a few months later.
One thing I would say is, one thing that would be nice, which we can't promise, but it was something that definitely is a future option, is to have a high-res texture pack. We offer all of our textures at double the resolution we actually ship them at. But there's several issues in trying to achieve that at the moment, mainly just the size of the build would obviously go enormously high. And that has costs associated with as well. On the back end side, there was some money, cost for bandwidth. So we also have some tasks in the pipeline to reduce the size of the build. So, this is stuff that's type of a higher level decision than we can make in our team. But maybe if we have the textures available and we have the technology to use them, we also save a bunch of memory on the build. Maybe we get to a point where it's more viable to have a high-res texture pack. And then the people that do have 20 gigs or whatever of memory will have a very real reason to use that memory. And, if you say double the resolution of every texture, that would be 4 times the texture memory. So our 3 gig texture limit might go to 12 gigs instead, at least. So 12 gigs, once you add on 4K and a few other things, you easily get to 16 to 20 gigs memory. So yeah, this is something in the future, definitely. There is some technologies as well in the future that we might use that could eat up some of that memory, things like ray tracing and SDFs, distance fields that are used for various pieces of technology. These all consume extra memory. We just have to make sure the game can still scale so that the people that have 6 gigs or whatever can still run the game, sensibly.
So there are a few things that potentially will come in the future that could eat up VRAM. So obviously the high resolution texture pack sounds great from a visual point of view. They said that might be troublesome because the build size of the game, the actual amount of gigabytes you have to download, would balloon massively. So hopefully we will get that, because the game already looks stunning, but I'd be really interested to see how it looks with the higher resolution texture pack. And then obviously things like ray tracing, which we've been talking about recently on the channel, they are going to do that, and they are doing that as we speak. And so VRAM usage will go up. So I suppose, to sum all this up, if you're buying a card, you probably want as much as possible. And that's been the case for forever, really, with VRAM. And there's numerous examples in the past where cars, as they've got older, have just slowed down because they've run out of VRAM. AMD tend to support this better than NVIDIA. NVIDIA, for some reason, are pretty stingy with their VRAM. And so you can find cars from AMD generally which have higher amounts of VRAM than NVIDIA. But sometimes it doesn't make any difference, because you don't want a card that's got loads of VRAM that just isn't very fast. So it's tricky. The main thing is, anybody running it, I guess, ultra wide or 4K, you really want to be looking at the cards with, I guess, 60 gigabytes upwards, if we take what Ali Brown is saying there to be true. But for those of us who are on the 4 gigabytes or 6 gigabytes, there's hope at least that we will still be able to run the game relatively well. But the reality is, those cards will start to just get too slow in general anyway. So you'll probably be looking to upgrade at some stage.